Buonissimo!
Che meraviglia!
Mamma mia!
Stupendo, l'ottimo!
Italia è bellissima! Margarita Forrest, oh my God, she is an icon, and I'm very, very excited to do the Crawl Italy with her.
When I found out that Matteo Gudicelli was going to be my crawl buddy, of course, I was absolutely thrilled.
I'm 50% Filipino, 50% Italian, and 100% ready to eat.
But I, on the other hand, I think I'm 100% Italian, but in my past life. Milano, rain or shine, you're still my happy place. This is where Matteo and I begin our epic 9-day food adventure. Welcome to the Crawl Italy.
Where else to begin but at Milan's magnificent Duomo, truly an architectural marvel. This landmark took over 6 centuries to complete. It is simply breathtaking. Right beside the Duomo is Galleria Vittorio Emanuele II. It is Italy's oldest active shopping mall and another of Milan's stunning landmarks.
I always still get goosebumps every time I walk through the Galleria. Right. You stand here in the center, there's just this like magical energy.
Exactly.
No? We better have pizza for lunch because this like super, super good guy who makes Neapolitan pizza, Gino Sorbillo, opened here in Milano.
Let's go eat it.
On one of the side streets of the Galleria is Gino Sorbillo. I've tried Gino Sorbillo in Napoli and New York, and it was divine. Considered by many to be the best pizzaiolo in Naples, I just had to take Matteo to the Milano branch.
Io prendo la cucina prima la mezza bufala e dopo lì. Perfetto.
Sì, sì.
Una mezza bufala con fresella. Dude, I was not prepared for the size of this ball of cheese. Imagine 1/2 kilo of mozzarella drizzled with olive oil surrounded by the sweetest, juiciest tomatoes.
This is just the second biggest mozzarella ball I've ever had.
What was the first?
I had one that was 800 grams.
No.
I swear to God, like this huge. And it was just amazing. I mean, like it was like a little volleyball.
Wow.
And then came my pizza, margherita con prosciutto crudo.
Ooh, Diego! Pizza.
Grazie, Diego!
Best pizza for Napoli, bye Diego!
Diego, grazie Diego!
I love this pizza. Neapolitan style pizza, no? It's very simple. And the dough, because it's very light, no? Very light. It's just beautiful. Like, I can look, two more cuts and I'm done.
The crust is a little bit on the soft side. Right? You notice the ends are puffy. It's not like with too much topping. Notice the proportion of the cheese and very little tomato sauce on it. And then even the prosciutto's just right.
In honor of being in the region of Lombardia, I ordered Gino Sorbillo's Pizza Lombardia.
Mine is a pizza bianca. So the cheese is a gorgonzola picante. So a spicy gorgonzola. With a special luganige, special sausage.
It's a salami,
super
no?
Simple, yeah.
So guys, how Italians eat the pizza when they get it by hand, they get it,
and then they fold the dough.
They fold it, no? Boom, like that.
I have to say the gorgonzola super.
Very good.
When I think of Italy, I think of gelato. Every city and every town in Italy most certainly has a good number of gelaterias. Venchi, both a chocolate store and a gelateria, is just a few minutes away. I get my favorite, stracciatella.
Mine is custard. Yummy.
If you go crazy over dried fruit and nuts like me, you have to drop by Noverasco. Cheers! The store is old-world elegance with the most amazing selection of exotic dried fruit and more.
Did I put it all in your mouth? You have to be fair. What I eat, you eat.
Okay, but you burn more than
you're making diet. You're giving our camera crew all the food.
Okay. Okay.
Cheers.
1, 2, 3, go.
Thank you.
Allora, so I'm not letting the day go by without an aperitivo. This is Milano after all, and having an aperitivo is a tradition.
Cheers!
Cheers!
Very nice.
You can't beat the view from Terrazza Aperol when the Duomo is lit up in all its glory. It's absolutely intoxicating.
So if you think we're calling it a night, we're not.
I'm so glad that I'm taking you to try one of my like secret places in Milano.
I'm very excited. It's called Ristorante
alla Cucina delle Langhe.
Okay.
It's a place where I've been coming to for like maybe the last almost 30 years.
30 years? So
yes.
I'm sure they know you in this restaurant.
No, and what's really nice is that like the menu never changes. Okay. It's like coming home.
Buonasera, Gianni.
Delle Langhe is like an institution in Milan. Even Tom Ford reserves a table for the whole week of the Milan Fashion Week. Ragu? Ragu is my favorite. I even named my dog Ragu. And guess what? The ragu in Delle Langhe is one of the best I've ever tried.
Oh my god.
How's it? What's that?
This is killer good. And that's really Piemontese, the thin handmade loaves.
I come here for Milanese specialties like the cotoletta, which is a breaded veal cutlet. Wow.
Look at that. It's very thin, Duda.
So you can see it's the veal chop has the bone right, still on it.
We ordered two kinds of cotoletta, one with cheese and one without.
Of course, the one with fontina is a little richer, but it's a nice touch. The breading is so nice and light. It's
very.
Just breadcrumbs, and then they like pan fry it in a little butter and olive oil.
And with a little lemon on top?
Yeah, the best. See, you're chomping off the bone. That's the best part, because the fat of the veal chop is there.
By the bone, the fat's right there, so it makes it extra special. So, don't be shy. Grab it, eat it, be happy.
You cannot come to Milano and not have ossobuco. That would be a sin.
So who's getting the marrow? Look at that, look at that. Oh my God, look, look. Oh, andame. There's a lot. Here.
Isn't that like fat?
Of course it's fat.
Like beautiful.
The best.
That's magical. No, I want it, but I don't think it's good for me. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't think it's healthy.
I'm like so much older than you. Sige na nga. Oh my God.
So this is one thing you learn about Tita Margarita Forrest. She loves anything and everything with fat.
Okay, guilty as charged. But how can I not? Fat is what makes food taste so good.
Cheers, Steph.
Cheers.